Myself, Lokesh Jain, Assistant Professor of Physics. This video lecture is for BSc Third Semester Physics of Mysore University. In this session, let us discuss about the statement and proof of maximum power transfer theorem for AC circuits. Any AC circuit consists of source connected to a load. As we know, according to Thevenin's theorem, any complex network can be resolved into one voltage source in series with one impedance. Hence, in this picture, it is represented as an AC network is in series with some load, that is, it is a circuit which represents the network according to Thevenin's theorem. Here is the statement of maximum power transfer theorem. In AC circuit, the maximum power transfer theorem is stated as, in a linear network having energy sources and impedances, the maximum amount of power is transferred from source to load impedance if the load impedance is the complex conjugate of the total impedance of the network. That is, if source impedance is R plus jX ohm, to have maximum power transfer, the load impedance must be R minus jX ohm, which is the complex conjugate. As we know, in an AC circuit, impedance is a combination of resistances and reactances. So here R represents the resistance and jX represents the reactance. Let us represent the source impedance as ZS and the load impedance as ZL. Let ZS is equal to R plus jX. In the circuit shown, for the delivery of maximum power from source to load, the value of ZL, that is the load impedance, should be equal to R minus jX, which is already said that it is the complex conjugate of the source impedance. Now let us consider ZL is equal to RL plus jXL and ZS is equal to R plus jX. A current I flows through the load. The value of the current can be given by I is equal to V by square root of R plus RL square plus X plus XL square. It is simplified by using the combination of resistances and the reactances. Since the current I is flowing through the load, now we can calculate the power delivered to the load. The power dissipated in load is due to resistive part of its impedance. So, power will be dissipated in RL only, that is the load resistance only. Let this power be represented as PL. Now, power is the product of I square and RL. Therefore, we can substitute for the above equation. We get PL is equal to V square RL divided by R plus RL square plus X plus XL square. For power to be maximized, the above equation must be differentiated with respect to XL and equated to 0. So here, XL is the variable quantity, hence it should be differentiated, and we can get another case where RL is variable. Maximum power transfer theorem is applicable only when load is variable. Now, differentiating above equation with respect to XL and equating to 0, so we get as follows. Hence, simplifying the equations, we get XL is equal to minus X. The above expression gives the relationship between the inductive part of impedance of source and load for maximum power transfer in an AC circuit. Substituting this value in the expression of power dissipated in load impedance, we get the value of PL as PL is equal to V square into RL divided by R plus RL whole square. Now, to get the relationship between load resistance RL and source network resistance R for maximum power transfer from source to load, we will again differentiate PL with respect to RL and equate it to 0. That is, dPL by dRL is equal to 0. By differentiating that, we get the following expressions. Simplifying the expressions, we arrive at RL is equal to R. That is, the resistance of the load is equal to the resistance of the source. Therefore, in AC circuits, if XL is equal to minus X and RL is equal to R, maximum power transfer occurs when the impedance of the load is complex conjugate of the source impedance. So that is, ZL is equal to Z star. Hence, for maximum power transfer from source to load impedance in an AC circuit, the necessary condition is that the value of load impedance should be equal to R minus Jx if the source impedance is R plus Jx. Since R minus Jx is complex conjugate of R plus Jx, we can say that the value of load impedance must be complex conjugate of source impedance. Thus, the maximum power transfer theorem in AC circuit is proved. On this theorem, we can calculate different cases and we can find out the value of the load impedance and the source impedance. Thank you.